That is the moral values. The values which the world is expecting to be exposed by you. And those values, we have provided you with a platform, that is school. Your beloved Mercer International School is the platform for you all, in order that you will be able to practice, in order that you will be ready to face those challenges which the world is very eagerly awaiting for you both. And those values, at least the platform in the school, is the discipline, the moral values, the rules and regulations, and I'm sure that you always object to all those rules and regulations at this stage. But I'm sure that they are always meant not to punish you. They are meant to make you very strong, to make you a very, very disciplined person, to make you prepare to face all those challenges which you have to accept in this bitter world. And I'm sure that all of you, and particularly my grade 12 girls will be leaving us. I was telling them this afternoon that I'm sure that you are going to forget us, because you have a big challenge. You have got yet so many other obligations to fulfill. You will come across so many temptations. You will come across so many hurdles and obstacles which you have to solve it for yourself. Nobody else now onwards, when you leave our podium, is going to help you. You always remember, my darling, that when you are tear apart from what to do, what is good and what is bad and what is right and what is wrong, and my conscience says something and my daddy says something and Uncle Rahul says all those things, forget all those things and always ask your conscience. Always ask your conscience whether this is the right thing I have to do, whether I'm going to do this thing is good or bad for myself. You'll definitely get the answers. And while you are waiting for the answers, I'm sure that you have a lot of experience. You have those words of Uncle Rahul and your teachers and your daddy will haunt you. And I'm sure that you will be able to come across the right decision. And I'm sure that you will never let us down wherever you go. My blessings are always there. I would like to see that you come out as a shining star. And whenever you enter my office next, after you have left, come with something, so that not only myself, the world is proud of you. When I was in Sydney other day, there are three girls came to me and they bow down and touch my feet and they say, "Do you know me?" Well, unfortunately, I say that I can only say that you are my students of Mercer International School. What is my name? I said that, "Look, better I can't know." And one of them said that I am MBBS, I've done my this. Others said that I've done my BBA and I am now working in this particular organization, so on. And so I was totally, the tears rolled in my eyes and I thought that all what has been done, these are the biggest gift you could ever give it to me, that those girls have already given me. At the same time, I already told them that I hope you have not let me down. And the girl said, "No, Uncle, we remember your words." And they did also remember when they came to my house for dinner what I told them. They said, "I'm married, I have got one daughter, and I am proud of your daughter." I also expect the same thing from each and every person. To my colleagues, well, I have already appreciated your hard work, your sincerity, your dedication and devotion to make my girls so happy tonight. And please try to be the role model for those values which we are now trying to inculcate in all these girls. Because the teaching is a very noble profession. And that will shape the destiny of all these girls. You are the one who can guide them, who can lead them to the right destiny, to the right place. All the best. Good luck to you.